Morning students, welcome back in our chemistry lecture. Here today we will do the fourth chapter. According to your syllabus studies, we are doing the fourth chapter. Which one here? Chemical bonding and the molecular structure. This is your fourth chapter. Before starting this chapter, we will discuss about already know you very well. That is in our universe that about 118 elements are present. Clear? And they exist as a matter. Clear? Out of that 118 elements, that is some metals, some non-metals, some metalloids. But out of 118 elements that have a noble gases are also present. Noble gases are such element that exist in a independent form. Means they does not react with any other element. Here only the noble gases are the such elements that exist in a independent means that they do not react with any other elements. Rest of our elements or the metals present in the universe are depend with the each other, means they are combining with each other, and when they are combining, that is a lot of forces are present, a lot of factors are there that depends upon their shape, clear, and which forces are present, and size, ionization, enthalpy, that a lot of factors are depend when they are interact with each other, when they are comes nearby each other, clear. And in this chapter we will do the detail about this. Clear? Now firstly, what is a chemical bond? What is a chemical bond and how they are interact with each other? How they are form the bond? How they are form the molecules? That is a chemical bond is what is the attractive forces which hold together the constitute atoms, molecules or ions in chemical species. What is the chemical bond? That is the attractive forces between the present in the atoms, molecules and ions to form a chemical species, to form a new substance, that is called chemical bond. Clear? Next is, now develop the critical thinking in your mind, that is why the atoms are combined. About that is a, we can say that is attractive forces is present between them, but why they combine with each other, why the metals, non-metals or the, we can say that the elements are combined with the atom are combined with each other, why the need to combine them, clear, which factors are dependent, that is the when they are combined with each other, that is first is tendency to occur noble gas configuration, or we can say that octet group. Now the most important question, why they are combining with each other, why the atoms, molecules or ions are combined with each other. First reason is why they are combined to each other, they are combined with each other to get the noble gas configuration. First is what is tendency to give the noble gas configuration or to complete their octet, and we can say that that is the NS2 NB6. This is the noble gas general configuration of group 18. Group 18 means noble gas. Clear? They are combining to give the noble gas configuration because in that when they are completing their octet, they become neighbor. Clear? So that's why they have a tendency to, they are combining with each other. Second one is reason is to cure minimum energy. Second one is that to give the minimum energy. What is the reason that? That is, if they have a minimum energy, it means that they have a stable configuration. They have a stable configuration. It means that they have a stability, they have a more stability in nature. They have a more stable. Minimum energy, they cure a minimum energy when they are complete their objective. When they are in a minimum energy level, it means they are most stable in the nature. See? First thinking is clear, no? Why they are combining, why the atoms are combining with each other. First reason is that it tendency to cure the noble gas configuration. Because in a noble gas configuration, after attaining the noble gas configuration, they does not react with any other element. Clear? And second one is to cure the minimum energy. If they have a minimum energy, it means they are stable in nature. They are more stability. If they are stable in the nature and they are becomes the more stable configuration. Clear? Now, next we will do the Lewis symbol. In our 10th, we have already discussed about the Lewis symbol. But in the 10th standard, we have a say the electron dot structure. Yes, now we have discussed the Lewis symbol. In a Lewis symbol, that is in a 10th standard, we say that the electron dot structure. Electron dot structure or Lewis symbol means, in a simple way, we can say that valence electrons. Yes, in a simple meaning, that is a Lewis symbol meaning, that is a valence electron. How many electrons are present in a outermost shell? That is represented by Lewis symbol. Clear? Now, I will explain with an example. For example, we are taking the example of oxygen. O is represented to oxygen and atomic number of oxygen is 8. And configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Clear? Now, in this, how many electrons are? When we are seeing about the valence electron, then firstly we see the principal quantum number. In a case of oxygen, that is the principal quantum number is 8. That is 2. That is, we are adding the both. 6. 2 plus 6. It means in a case of oxygen, 6 electrons are present. It means valence electron. How many valence electrons are present in a case of oxygen? 6 valence electrons are present. So, oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Clear? This is represented the Lewis symbol. In a 10th we say that electron dot structure. Na? But in a, now we are in a plus 1. So in that case, that is 6 electrons are present in a outermost shell. That is the valence electron is how many? 6. So it is called the Lewis symbol. Clear? Now we will take the more examples. Now, oxygen is an example of a Lewis symbol of any atom. Clear? If we are taking an example of any ion. Ion means either they are the anion or cation. Clear? And if I am taking the examples of fluorine negative. In a case of a fluorine, that is 9 electrons are present. Atomic number of fluorine is 9. Negative means they are from the anion. Anion means they are gaining the 1 electron. Now the fluorine negative, fluorine anion has a 10 electrons. Now the configuration becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Now in their case is that how many electrons, valence electrons are there? 2 plus 6 means 8 electrons are there. Now we will represent the Lewis symbol. Fluorine, firstly we will represent the symbol. After that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 electrons are present around the fluorine. And this is called the Lewis symbol. Clear? And in the Lewis symbol, that is they are how many valence electrons are present in the outermost shell, that are represented by Lewis symbol. Clear? Now, next we will do the next topic. Now, our next topic is the octet rule and the modes of chemical combination. Firstly, what is the octet rule and how they are completed their octet? What are the methods to complete their octet? Firstly, what is the octet rule? Octet rule means that they have a tendency to complete its outermost shell. Means they have a tendency to acquire the noble gas configuration. This is called the octet rule. Clear? And next one is the modes of chemical combination. Modes of a chemical combination means how they are complete their octet. What are the methods to complete their octets? There are the two methods that we have already discussed. That is, there are the two methods to form a chemical combination. First year, ionic. Second one is covalent. Ionic bond or the equivalent. Here, first method is your ionic bond or the equivalent. Not the equivalent here, the electrovalent. First method is the ionic bond or the electrovalent bond. Second one is the covalent bond. Here there are the two methods, there are the two modes to chemical combination. First year ionic, second one year covalent. Clear? Now firstly we have discussed the ionic bond in a detail. Now in a case of ionic bond, ions means they are form anion or the cation. Means what we say that is the ionic bonds are formed by the transfer of electron. Transfer of electron means either they are losing the electron or they are gaining the electron. In that cases, they are such a type of a bond is called the ionic bond. Here, what is the ionic bond? That is the bond is formed by the transfer of electrons. Either they are gaining the electron or they are accepting the electron. Their bond is called ionic bond. Clear? Now, one example is here. Sodium chloride that we have discussed in 10th also. That is, sodium means Na. That they have a configuration 2, 8, 1. Now in the case of a sodium, it have a what the sodium do? It is either gain the electron or the lose the electron. That is, in a case of a sodium, sodium will lose the one electron to complete its octet. Means it form a Na positive plus electron. Okay? It means it lose the one electron and complete its octet. Second one is the chlorine. Chlorine is the atomic number 17 and configuration is 287. Clear? Now in that case, in a case of chlorine, it has a tendency to gain the electron. Means one electron is gained, then it becomes chlorine negative, means 288. Clear? Now in a case of sodium chloride. Clear? In a case of a sodium chloride, they have a sodium has a one electron in the outermost shell. But in the case of a chlorine, they have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 electron in the outermost shell. Now how they complete their octet? That is, a sodium lose one electron and chlorine gains one electron. And sodium form a Na positive and Cl 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 in next. And such type of a bond is called, that is, a bond is formed by the transfer of electrons. Sodium has lost one its electron and the chlorine is gained its one electron. And such type of a bond is called ionic bond. Now, I am taking a more example. That is in a case of a sodium sulfide. Sodium sulfide. And a sodium sulfide is represented by type of a body is called a ionic bond. Clear. Next one here. Now the next topic is our low ionization in health. Means we are doing the factors affecting the ionic bond. What are the factors that affect the ionic bond? Means which factors are depend with that ionic bonds become stronger or the weak. Here, first factor is that lower ionization enthalpy. Low ionization enthalpy. It means that firstly, what is the ionization enthalpy? That is amount of energy required to remove an electron from an isolated gaseous atom. That is called the ionization enthalpy. Clear? Now, if the ionization enthalpy is low, it means low ionization enthalpy means we are easily removed electron from our outermost shell. It means if we are moving the first moving the electron easily, it means they form a ionic bond easily, means they are donating the electron easily. Clear? If the ionization enthalpy is low, it means it is easy to form, it is easy to form ionic bond. Clear? Factors affecting here, the first is the low ionization enthalpy. It means if the ionization enthalpy of any atom is low, it means they have a tendency to form ionic bond easily. They are easy form ionic bond. Second one is here, high. Clear? Firstly, what is the electron gain enthalpy? That is the amount of energy released when the electron is added in the outermost shell. That is called electron gain enthalpy. Now, how the high electron gain enthalpy depends upon the ionic bond? It means that if they have a tendency, high tendency to gain the electron, if they have a high tendency to gain the electron, it means they have a easy to form a ionic bond. Yes, first factor is the low ionization enthalpy. If they have a easy release the electron from outermost shell, then the ionic bond is formed easily. Second one is the high electron gain enthalpy. That is the energy released when the electron is added in the outermost shell. If they have a high tendency to gain the electron, then they form a easy ionic bond. Here, next one factor is your high lattice enthalpy. Next one factor is your lattice enthalpy. Here, firstly, what is the lattice enthalpy? It's a new concept for you. That is the electron gain enthalpy and the ionization enthalpy we have discussed in the chapter 3. But the lattice enthalpy is what it is firstly denoted by U. And what it is? The amount of energy released when the free ions combine together to form one mole of a crystal. Means when the free ions, means when the cations and freely moving cations and anions are combined with each other to form one mole of a crystal. That is called lattice enthalpy. Clear? Now, how the lattice enthalpy depends upon the ionic bond? Clear? If the free ions are combined with each other, if the lattice enthalpy is high, means they have a high tendency, means free ions have a high tendency to form a combine to form a one mole of a crystal, then they have a easy form of ionic bond. Here, ionic bond is depends upon the three factors. First, your ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy must be low. Second one is the electron gain enthalpy. And third one is lattice enthalpy. If the lattice enthalpy is more, it means that they are easy form a bond. The ions are easy form a bond. Okay? So that's affecting the ionic bond. In the next session, we have discussed about the covalent bond. Thank you. Good morning, students. Welcome back in our chemistry lecture. Here, today we will do the fourth chapter. According to your syllabus, that is, we are doing the fourth chapter. Which one is?